My name is Burkhard Bönsche, and I'm a senior lecturer in computer science and the director of the Computer Graphics Group at the University of Auckland. My research is in visual computing, which is the intersection of computer graphics, AR/VR, computer vision, and human-computer interaction. From a young age, I was fascinated by humans' ability to process and use visual information. Most humans will have difficulties processing a spreadsheet with millions of data points. If you see a picture of the medical imaging data, a brain or a heart, then we can easily perceive relevant information. The picture is worth more than 1,000 words. But visual computing is more than just representing visual information. It can also be used for enjoyment, for training, education, and even for rehabilitation and behavioral change. We develop visualizations to improve the understanding and interaction with complex data. An example is this mixed reality simulation of a robot to remove screws from ceiling beams. Our second goal is the use of virtual reality for education and training. We develop a VR experience for teaching the function and structure of DNA. Students will be able to better understand the function and also to understand the scale better and memorize concepts better. Our third goal is the use of visual information for healthcare. Using virtual reality, we can make exercises more enjoyable and more effective by integrating them into a game. By having virtual reality concepts which require the user to do certain movements. Or we could also integrate cognitive concepts that we can train both the physical abilities and the cognitive abilities of the user. Our research shows that visual computing can be used to improve educational outcomes, to improve physical and mental fitness of users, and even to change behavior. The key advantage of visual computing is that it can make complex information more accessible to both experts and non-experts. An example is a visualization of the deformation of the heart. This would be hard to understand by just looking at the medical imaging data sets. However, by visualizing it, we can show the strain in the heart, how much the heart muscle contracts. Even a non-expert can see which parts of the heart are not functioning correctly. Due to consumer-level virtual reality technologies becoming more widely accessible and mobile devices becoming computationally more powerful, we've got now the ability to use visual computing in virtually every aspect of modern life in order to improve it. And we found that our research can help people working in biology, health science, architecture, and many other areas. I enjoy working with the University of Auckland because they've got a strong commercial focus and also connection to incubators, which makes it really exciting to work with young companies, many of them originating from our own student body.